Students when they were in seventh grade and to serve as their campus administrator this year. It has been both an honor and a joy. A couple of quick reminders as we begin our celebration. We want to silence your phones. If you would like to take pictures during the ceremony, you're free to come up and stand in front of the stage, but we're just asking that you do not come up the stairs. Please be mindful that you don't want to block the view of others behind you. So after you've walked up to the platform, if you choose, and taken your picture, please clear away so that other families can come and have that same opportunity. Remember, always throughout the evening, to maintain a good 6-foot social distance between each of the family groups. We also are asking that everyone remain with their mask on, covering their nose and their mouth throughout the evening, just out of respect for all involved. Cheering. We love to cheer for our graduates, and we encourage you to cheer. But remember that each family would like to hear the name of their child read at the appropriate time. And so when your student is receiving their diploma, cheer for them, but then be mindful of remaining silent so that the next name can be heard that follows. Also, remember, we are in an indoor setting, so we are asking that there be no artificial noisemakers. Let's make this ceremony enjoyable for everyone who's attending. Now, please join me in a word of prayer. To the one who has called us each by name, as we hear the names of each student spoken aloud today, and as they receive their certificate of promotion, let us also hear your voice calling each one present to receive a word of purpose and direction in life. We celebrate finishing a chapter in our history, that we may continue from this day and this place to celebrate outstanding stories that surround us every day. And so, with family and friends who have gathered to encourage and support these students, we welcome the presence of our Creator, who has anticipated this moment from the beginning of time. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Good evening, everyone. I still vividly remember first coming to Fremont Christian in seventh grade. I felt really lonely since I didn't know anyone here, and I missed my friends from my old school. But as time went on, I started to make a few friends. We had some really fun memories together, like the time when a hummingbird accidentally got trapped in Mr. Liston's classroom, and we all had to create a long paper ball held up by rulers to try and guide it out of the classroom. We all know that the years of 2020 through 2021 have been full of change, challenges, and so different from the normal flow of life we were so used to. We've even had to have over a year of online schooling instead of the usual in-person classes. It's been really difficult for all of us. Yet during this time, I've learned to focus on the positives because there are many good things that come out of it if you look for them. No, not just the open book tests, but I have realized many things about my own self during this time. Keeping a steady relationship with God has helped me the most through these tough years. During the pandemic, I've grown closer to my family, and we've all become more resilient because of the challenges we've had to unexpectedly face. In addition to having God and family, I would have not made it through middle school and socially distanced learning without my teachers. All my teachers have been kind, supportive, approachable, and have always gone the extra mile to be flexible with this new learning environment. I want to thank God, my family, and my teachers for a memorable school year. I would like to end by saying how proud we should be about how far we've come and have faith in how far we can go as we head towards the next chapter in our lives. Thank you all for being here today and supporting everyone around you through this year especially.
some of you may know me. I'm sure many of you don't. This is because I transferred here to FCS in 2020, the year quarantine started. Even though these past months were pretty hectic, I've been welcomed warmly and kindly at FCS. Fellow classmates and teachers have made me feel more comfortable at my new school. And even though I have mostly interacted with my classmates over Zoom, I already feel like I fit in. So I'm thankful for all my teachers and everyone in all my classes, as they have made my transition from school to school easier. Everyone at FCS has been extremely patient and understanding, knowing that there's a pandemic that has shut down the world. And because of this, I know that many of us here have had to endure hardships during this time in COVID. But I'm also grateful to God that we've made it thus far. I also think that it is important to thank FCS for pushing through to make coming back to school normal. From preschoolers to seniors, FCS has taken the needed precautions to allow students back onto campus. Ever since the time we were allowed back on campus, I've not only been greatly impressed with the safety of the system that the school has come up with, but I've also been happy to be around classmates to bond with, both now and in our future high school years together. And speaking of our transition into high school, it will no doubt be a new experience for us all. One of the many learning opportunities that I am personally looking forward to in high school is computer science discoveries. I want to get good at coding, and I've heard that we also get to learn how to make websites. I expect such activities to be challenging, but that's one of the reasons why I look forward to it. Learning how to overcome difficult challenges in school will hopefully help us overcome difficult challenges in life. In our generation, not only will we need to deal with current and future pandemics, we will also be faced with other issues, such as severe climate changes due to wildfires and global warming. Whether we want to or not, our generation needs to prepare for such challenges, so the more we are not afraid to take on these challenges, the less scarier challenges will be. Yet the best part of going to a Christian school is knowing that we never have to face challenges alone. God has provided us with loving parents, teachers, caregivers, friends, and classmates to help us through these challenges in life. But most important of all, God has provided his son, Jesus Christ, who has already overcome the worst challenge mankind has ever faced, death itself. And this same Jesus promises to never forsake us or to leave us when we accept him as our Lord and Savior of our lives. This is because God loves us so much. So my challenge to all of us as we go into high school together is this. Let us work hard in our classes, learn as much as we can, and use our talents, gifts, and knowledge to bless this world as salt and light, the way Jesus intended for us to do. And in this way, we will give glory to God and benefit mankind. In this way, we will have fulfilled God's greatest commandment for his people, to love God and to love others. Let our generation be a godly blessing for future generations to come. Congratulations, future class of 2025. Thank you.
Good evening. Tonight, we are pleased to recognize students for some well-deserved awards. Students, as you hear a name called, please stand. The ACSI Creative Writing Festival celebrates the talents of emerging young writers and provides students with the opportunity to receive valuable feedback as they are encouraged to develop their writing skills. Categories include free verse poetry, rhymed poetry, essay, short story, song lyrics, and playwriting. Superior, excellent, and good scores are awarded with ribbons. Congratulations to all of our young writers. Toby Hsu. Toby received a score of excellent. Micah Chin Sel. Micah received a score of superior and was recommended for inclusion in an ACSI publication. Henry Vargas. Henry's playwriting submission will be published in this year's 2020-2021 ACSI Youth Anthology. You may be seated. The President's Education Award Gold is sponsored by the U.S. Department of Education, recognizing academic excellence. To receive a gold certificate, a student must maintain a grade point average of 3.5 or higher and above average scores in English or math on a nationally recognized test. Micah Chinsell, Toby Shu, Veronica Nguyen, Ayana Ordonez, Noah Root, Sahana Sanga, Masuma Shira, Albert Shi, Kaylee Swart, Leah Tagel, Jada Williams, Alan Chang, Shayna Chris, Ethan Ho, Kayla Lee, and Lauren Trim. You may be seated. Fremont Christian School honors outstanding achievement in junior high academic disciplines. Only one award medal is given in each subject area. These students are wearing them tonight. Recipients are those who exhibit outstanding academic achievement, a commitment to the academic integrity, and a superior level of academic curiosity. For excellent in Bible, Toby Shu. For excellence in social studies, Micah Chinsell. For excellence in English, Sahana Sanga. For excellence in science, Lauren Trin. For excellence in band, Johanna So. For excellence in choir, Kirsten Villagracia. And for excellence in math, Jenny Jiaqi Guo. You may be seated. At this time, I would like to turn your attention to your programs and recognize the merit scholars. These students were chosen for the academic achievement, commitment to school community, and character. They each earn a four-year renewable scholarship for Fremont Christian High School. They're wearing a silver honor cord this evening. Micah Chinsell, Ethan Ho, Toby Shu, Daniel Lowe, Kayla Lee, Veronica Nguyen, Sahana Sanga, Albert Shi, Masuma Shira, Jada Williams. You may be seated. I'm proud to present certificates to the eighth grade class. Johanna So. Ella Gross. Masuma Shira. Jada Rose Williams. Sahana Kaur Sanga. Daniel Tobiah Levi Shu. Zoe K. Ong. Alan Chang. Micah Josiah Chinsell. Shayna Chris. Matthew Christopher. Joseph Stephen Dutra. Brandon Ken Fung. Jenny Guo Jiaqi is not present this evening. Emma Hebert. Ethan Timothy Ho is not present this evening. Daniel Tianfu Lou. Kayla To Lee. Ethan Matthew Poten. Veronica Grace Nguyen. Ayana Mazo Estabillo Ordonez. Noah Root. Albert Shi is not present this evening. Kaylee Elizabeth Swart. Cecilia Rose Tagle. Shreyas Telesila is not present this evening. Lauren Trin. Bella Urizar. Henry James Vargas. Kirsten Emily Villagracia. Joshua Zhang Haobo is not present this evening.
Now, in order to maintain a safe social distancing, we're going to ask that we allow the students to leave the building, and then Dr. Meyer and I will come down to the floor, and we are going to escort each family individually through either the set of doors the students exited or this set of doors. So if you would remain in your seat after the prayer, after the students leave, we will dismiss each family group one at a time in a safe way to maintain our good distancing. I'm going to share with you a passage from the book of James, chapter 1, verse 5. It says, "But if any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask God, who gives to all generously and without reproach, and it will be given to him." Let me offer up this prayer for wisdom for these graduates. Dear God, we ask that you help our children to walk in your wisdom and grace. We pray for spiritual eyes and discernment in all things. Help them to be wise leaders and influencers in this generation, not conformed to the world, but transformed by your power. We ask that you would equip them with all that they need to make a difference for your purposes. Help them to live as salt and light in a dark world that so desperately needs to know your truth. We ask for your power to help them walk continually in honesty and integrity. Build within them deep godliness, that they would be more concerned about their character than their reputation. We pray that they would seek to bring honor to you throughout their lives, that they would have a vision and a heart for the world. Extend their boundaries and give them incredible influence. Make their hearts and spirits open to every plan and purpose you have for them, and to be willing to go boldly wherever you call. We pray this all in the name of our Creator and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Congratulations to the eighth grade class.